So welcome back to the next topic, children. Now the next topic after concentration will be suspension and colloids. So through this PPT, I will be showing you the actual difference between suspension and colloids. Now there is an example that if you stir 2 tablespoons of iced tea, you know what is iced tea, cold tea, mixed into 16 ounces of glass of water. Okay. 16 ounces of glass of water, you would make a delicious summer drink, because iced tea, we prefer iced tea during summers. If you let the glass sit out on the counter for several days, would that drink be separated into its parts? What do you think? If you keep that glass of iced tea and after a few days when you come back, will you see different parts of the content or the solution separated? See, the next topic is solutions, suspensions and colloids. Okay, let's move on further. What is our goal? What will we achieve here? To classify the mixtures as solutions, suspensions or colloids. It is all about the particles now. The size of particles has a great effect on the properties of a mixture. If the size of the particle is very small, then the solute can easily dissolve in solvent. But the size is, if it is very big, it will not dissolve in the solvent. You must observe a mixture of mixture's properties before deciding whether it is heterogeneous or homogeneous. These things we have already done, so there won't be any problem. Mixtures get declassified as solutions, suspensions or colloids. Now you see, solutions, because the things are already been done, so it won't take much time. When iced tea mixed in water is kept, it is an homogeneous mixture. You see, iced tea will form a homogeneous mixture. So when substances dissolve and form a homogeneous mixture, the mixture is called solution. Children, these things we have already done. Okay, and we also know that solution has two parts. One is the solvent and the other one is the solute. So iced tea, the solvent is water, okay, and the tea are leaves are the solute. Now children, these were the properties of solution. This also we have done, so I don't think there will be any issues with this, right? The next thing which we are going to do here is suspension. Now children, if I ask you to mix little bit of flour, what is flour? Atta. Mix little bit of flour or chalk powder in water, and I ask you to take a spoon and dissolve it. What will you see, or what will you find out? You will see, or you will say that, ma'am, atta or chalk powder is not getting dissolved in water. Okay, though you have shaken it, though you have stirred it, still this is not getting dissolved in water. So such type of mixture is called suspension. Even if I tell you to take little bit of mud and mix it in water to make a muddy water, that is also an example of suspension, because the contents of solute will not get dissolved in solvent, and you can easily see or make out solute and solvent separately, right? That is what is suspension. See here, properties of suspension. It is a heterogeneous mixture. Now why do we call it as a heterogeneous mixture? Because the solute is not getting dissolved in the solvent, so it is a heterogeneous mixture. Second thing, if you want to separate this, the layers will separate. Now if you keep a glass full of muddy water and keep it aside for some time, you will see that the mud settles down and the water is separate. Now you can make out two different layers. You will say at the bottom of the glass there is mud and at the top of the mud there is water. So you can make out two separate layers, right? Then if I ask you to filter it, you can also filter it. You can separate the mixtures by filtration. Now this filtration part was not possible in the case of solutions. If you remember, I told you, you cannot filter the components of solution, right? Then particles are larger. Now the particles in suspension are of larger size. Like in solution, I told you the particles are very small, but in suspension, the particles are larger in size. And they also scatter the light. That means they show Tyndall effect. So these are the properties of suspension. Okay. Children, next topic is colloids. You see, colloids contain some particles that are intermediate between those of solution and those of suspension. That means, children, the particles of colloid are not very small nor they are very big. That means they are bigger than solution particles but smaller than suspension particles. Okay, examples include peanut butter is a colloid which you eat. Pudding is a colloid, jello is a colloid, whipped cream is a colloid, and the fog, dhund, is also a colloid, right? Properties of colloid, children, do not separate into layers. Now, if I ask you to mix milk in water and keep a glass of that mixture and do not disturb that mixture for some time. And if I ask you to say whether you can see that milk has separated from water, what will you say? No, the milk has not separated from water. That means in a colloid, you cannot see different layers separating. Iska matlab, colloid looks like a homogeneous mixture, but it is not homogeneous. It is a heterogeneous mixture. Mind my words, children. Though colloids look like homogeneous, but they are not homogeneous. They are heterogeneous mixtures. Okay. Next, particles will not become trapped. Now, the particles are small. They are not very small, but still they are small, and because they are small, they can pass through filter paper. So you will not be able to separate the mixture through filtration. If I ask you to take a mixture of milk and water and I tell you to separate them by filtration, can you do that? No, you cannot separate milk from water by filtration. Then third property is it can scatter the light. It can scatter the light. That means it will show Tyndall effect. Colloids and suspension appear cloudy. Unlike solutions, which is much clearer. Solutions are very clearer, but colloid and suspensions are not that clear, they are cloudy. Okay, so colloids and solutions will not separate. Now mark here, colloids and solutions will not separate through filtration. So I hope this things is clear with you. Examples of colloid I will be doing in the next video. Okay.